Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and I'm bringing you another Junk Gaming Videos production of Mac Daddy Road to the Show here in MLB 15, the show on the PS4. Mac Daddy in AAA with the Minnesota Twins organization. He's hitting a bouncer to second base, and why do they always barehand everything? That play sort of made sense, I guess, but anything that's a chopper, even if it's hard hit, they'll barehand, which seems a little strange. This is going to be a single and an RBI. Bases remain loaded as Mac Daddy drives one in. 6-1 is the deficit right now in the sixth, however, as Nightfall hits the stadium here, but he is going to be able to hit this one to center field and to the fence. Run into second base, and he'll be up standing with a double. Oh, that misses the cutoff, man. I don't think he would have gotten to third either way. This is going to be grounded to his left. He makes a little bit of a high throw to first, but gets his man. And we have a 6-4 game in the top of the seventh now. Runner in scoring position. That's not going to get him home. That is a ground out to second base. So Mac Daddy has two hits on the night in a loss. So Mac Daddy performing pretty well here at the AAA level, but obviously he's having dreams of being up at the big club now. He does have some versatility in the infield. Oh my goodness, did you see that? That ball hits the first base bag and skips right up into the air and out into right field. So no chance to make that play. Wait a second. I know the Twins traded for JD Martinez in a previous episode, but why is he in AAA? He must have really regressed quickly with his skills, but right here, he's going to go ahead and drive Mac Daddy home for the first run of the game. Mac Daddy's now going to ground into a easy double play. Not really what he wanted to accomplish in that at-bat. Still 1-0 in the top of the sixth. 2-0 count, hitters count, and he's going to be able to hit this one to right field for a single. Mac Daddy is on first base with a solid hit. 2-2 count, and he's taken off. This is going to be a throw down, and they catch him stealing. Oh, Mac Daddy cannot steal second base right there. Still 1-0, top of the eighth. Oh, look at that. He goes out and just slaps that in to right field, and now he's getting greedy, trying to go for two. I don't think he had any business trying to go for two right there. Yikes. But that was an interesting use of hitting there. Whoa, Mac. I think you hurried that one a little bit. Luckily, there's a dugout screen there, and it keeps the runner from advancing. This throw, a little bit better right there. So game is over, but yeah, not a bad effort right there by Mac Daddy in a 1-0 victory for his Rochester Red Wings. You see the stats right there so far as he's moving forward in the AAA career. Oh, I love Capital Field. I love all these minor league fields. I think they're really well done. I like this one a lot. He's going to get caught off base here. Come on, Mac. You got to be more careful than that, buddy. Whoa. Fourth inning, no score. All right. He's clearly getting bored out there because he's trying to make little games for himself here. Like, can I get back to the base? Ooh, that was a terrible throw. And he's going to get caught up. Ooh, luckily he gets back. The catcher did a really nice job of backing that off and playing that off the dugout screen. So this is a base hit to center field. Runner is going to move up to second ahead of him. So you got first and second. So Mac Daddy getting on base. It's a little bit of adventure when he does get there. He had a nice turn earlier, and look at that little glove flip. Mac Daddy does complete the double play. Some very innovative fielding going on here in the middle infield for Rochester. 8-1 Norfolk, though, and this is going to be a hit to left. So Mac Daddy's on again. But can they make a comeback here? They're down quite a hefty score, and now they lose this game 8-4. So there you go. That's going to wrap up this game, and I think we've got a spotlight coming up before the next game starts involving Mac Daddy.
Prospect Spotlight. Mac Daddy is our man to watch. He's coming off a very nice game in which he racked up four hits and just looked dialed in at the plate.
Yeah, anytime you get yourself four base knocks in a game, you're doing something right. You might have gotten a couple of gifts in terms of good pitches to hit, but, you know, it's not about the pitches you get. It's what you do with them. And from what I saw, balls were flying all over the yard off his bat. Well, that performance was big for his team, and I'm sure they're hoping he can do it again in this one.
All right, lineups and first pitch are coming up next. Stay tuned for that right here on the show.
You heard it right there. Mac Daddy dialed in, getting four hits in that last game. Let's see if he can do the same in this game. Second inning, he rockets that one to left center field. It's got some carry, and it's going to be off the wall one hop. That's going to be a double at least. You know him. He might try for three. Here he goes. Relay's got to be good, and nope, he's going to be standing up there at third base with the triple. So Mac Daddy already making a difference in this one. It's 2-2 in the fourth inning, and he'll slap that one to left center field. That'll be down for a hit. Nice job in this episode of going the opposite way with pitches and taking what he gets there. Easy grounder to second base. Throws over to get him. Nice job right there. 4-3 Rochester in the fifth. Two runners on. Mac Daddy smacks this one to center field. It's got some carry. It could get out of here, and it will. Three-run homer to dead center field, and that is going to extend the Rochester lead. Great job by Mac Daddy, a big daddy dinger to center field. And as he rounds the bases, 32 points for the three-run solid contact home run. Way to go, Mac Daddy. He drove home J.D. Martinez and somebody else there. Let's watch this again. Straight dead on center field. He got all of that pitch and deposits it out on the grassy area there that serves as the hitter's backdrop. 7-3 now in the seventh inning. Runner at third base. Can he get another RBI? Well, he can do better than that. He lashes that one to right and gone. It gets out of here in a hurry off that wall. I don't know if that's a bullpen out there or what that is, but he smacks it off that wall, and that got out very, very quickly. That was a line drive style. That's actually very good. It hit that wall and not a section of fans, because that could have done some damage right there. Pitcher, look at his knees just buckle when that pitch is hit. He knew it. Everybody knew it. It's 9-3 in the eighth. Oh, my goodness. He's already had a monster game, and he's looking for more. That one's down, and it's another RBI. How many does he have in this game? He is just going nuts. The Twins got to be salivating watching the tape on this one. Yeah, your player of the game, Mac Daddy. Is that any wonder? Two home runs. He has five hits. We were wondering if he could duplicate the four-hit game. Nah, forget that. He'll have five in this one in a 10-3 victory. Rochester just pounds it out here. So a 13-11 record to start things out in this season. And these are two pretty good clubs going at it, actually. Runners at first and second, and that is a breaking pitch that was left up. He hit it well, but the right fielder tracks it down. So there you go. Mac's teammates obviously seen the ball quite well. They've put home four runs already, so he's up again in the second inning. This time he will get a hit, and this time again he goes opposite field. Nice job of doing that once again. And the fourth inning, it's 7-1 Rochester, and oh, he hits this one opposite field. But this time he's hitting right-handed, so he goes to right center. That's going to be extra bases. He will settle in to second with an extra base hit, a double to be exact. Sixth inning, still 7-1. This one he lifts in the air to right field. It is fairly deep, but it will be caught at the warning track. So he gives this a bid to take it out of the ballpark, but not quite enough. Missed it by a few feet at least. So eighth inning, 7-1. That one's hit right at the right fielder. Oh, wait, no. Did it one hop? I guess it one hopped him. Well, Mac will definitely take the hit. There you go. So he's on first base. And oh, this one is crushed to left field and gone over the fence and rolling up under that show ad out there. So Rochester adding on to the lead. Yeah, there we go. The Tide are getting swept under in this one here by the Red Wings. As that one will, what is it, 9-1 now? Something like that. As we're taking a while to circle the bases here. Oh, that's Miguel Sano, everybody. No wonder he crushed that. Okay, that makes sense. You got quite a hitter's row here in Rochester right now. Mac Daddy, J.D. Martinez, you got Sano. Good stuff. They win the game 9-5, and Miguel Sano is your player of the game. Good for him. As, wow, he had six RBI. He was not messing around. Nice game for Miguel Sano. That's going to wrap up this episode of Mac Daddy. I keep wanting to call him Max Smasher. He's not Max Smasher. He's Mac Daddy. And we'll see you next time.